Let's start a party now.
The recording of Grand Rock, it was so different opposed to the other records we did. We usually just go into the studio, record, go to a bar, get drunk, and go in the studio next day. We headed out into the Swedish forest. There's this old hippie studio from the 70s up in the Swedish woods, and there's this 50-year-old guy working there who's been working with every sort of music, from Swedish folk music to Jimi Hendrix jams he's been recording. So we figured, well, he was traveling with Swedish hippie bands in the 70s, so he should have an idea how to create a genuine 70s rock sound. So we took a few albums with us into the studio, showing the albums, and he was all like, yeah, I think this was the way they created the sound, and not by the push of a button or a pedal or something, a box, but the proper way of handicrafting, doing it probably the way they did do it back then.
Putting the mics in the right places and all that stuff, I guess.
He's even trying different thicknesses on the chords and shit like that, you know, just experimenting. And it was pretty fascinating seeing him at work. These days it's easy for rock to be revolutionary because everything is samples and loops these days. So to do like a 12-inch bar, blues bars would be revolutionary in itself. So, you bet. For albums that's out there, I guess we would have to put Nevermind the Bollocks is up there, I believe, for a classic rock album.
Funhouse, probably.
Yeah, Funhouse is definitely up there. I would sort of like to put a Byrds album or a Who album in there, but that would be tough because you have to fit the Rolling Stones record in there somewhere, too.
You can't really say three albums because there's so many, good albums. I'm for real. You see, I'm rocking 'cause the devil's got the dirt heel. I ain't got no time left, but I got sheep on my mind. And you're in deep shit, baby. Well, I'm in that line, right? Yeah, action rocking, that money burning. Well, I got us a bunch of rubbing.
Like five members from and put the band together. Well, Rob Tyner would be singing. Viva, viva, wow, vino!
I'd like to have Keith Moon in a band.
Keith Moon is on drums. I bet Lemmy's playing bass.
Probably. Angus Young.
Yeah. Little Richard.
Well, Elvis Presley on vocals wouldn't be too bad.
We had Rob Tyner on vocals, but
yeah,
I guess
they can do some split
yeah,
vocals,
I guess the King could
he could play some guitar as well.
Yeah.